Jesus said, the greatest among you should be like the youngest, and the one who rules like the one who serves. I am among you as one who serves. We welcome you to St. Patrick's Cathedral for this choral office of Evensong on the sixth Sunday of Easter, Rogation Sunday.
Thank you.
Here beginneth the 16th verse of the 4th chapter of the Song of Solomon. Awake, north wind, and come, south wind. Blow upon my garden to spread its spices abroad, that my beloved may come to his garden and enjoy the choice fruit. I have come to my garden, my sister and bride. I have gathered my myrrh and my spices. I have eaten my honeycomb and my honey, and drunk my wine and my milk. Eat, friends, and drink deep, till you are drunk with love. I sleep, but my heart is awake. Listen, my beloved is knocking. Open to me, my sister, my dearest, my dove, my perfect one, for my head is drenched with dew, my locks with the moisture of the night. Continuing to read at verse 6 in chapter 8, wear me as a seal over your heart, as a seal upon your arm, for love is strong as death, passion cruel as the grave. It blazes up like a blazing fire, fiercer than any flame. Many waters cannot quench love. No flood can sweep it away. If someone were to offer for love all the wealth in his house, it would be laughed to scorn. Here endeth the first lesson.
Lord, hear us, O Lord.
beginneth the 24th verse of the 22nd chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke. A dispute began as to which should be considered the greatest. But Jesus said, "Among the Gentiles, kings lord it over their subjects, and those in authority are given the title benefactor. Not so with you. On the contrary, the greatest among you must bear himself like the youngest, the one who rules like one who serves. For who is greater, the one who sits at table or the servant who waits on him? Surely the one who sits at table. Yet I am among you like a servant. You have stood firmly by me in my times of trial, and now I entrust to you the kingdom which my Father entrusted to me. In my kingdom you shall eat and drink at my table and sit on thrones as judges of the 12 tribes of Israel." Here endeth the second lesson.
Lord, let thy servant depart in peace.
Thank you. thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, guide and defend our rulers.
And mercifully
with righteousness,
and with thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people. Servants, that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
The Anthem.
Let us pray. Jesus said, "The greatest among you should be like the youngest, and the one who rules like the one who serves. I am among you as one who serves." We pray for a spirit of service in our lives. O Heavenly Father, whose blessed Son declared to his disciples, "I am among you as one who serves," take from us, we pray thee, the spirit of selfishness, and deepen within us the spirit of service, that we may think less of our own interests and more of the needs of others, after the perfect example of the same, thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. On this theme of service, we pray using words of St. Augustine of Hippo. Eternal God, the light of the minds that know you, the joy of the hearts that love you, the strength of the wills that serve you, grant us so to know you that we may truly love you, so to love you that we may fully serve you, whom to serve is perfect freedom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray that we may be guided by God in our response to human need, both in when to respond and by what means. Lord Jesus, you were always ready to listen to those who cried out to you. You gave us ears to hear. May we listen to all we meet and to those who come to us in trouble. Remind us daily that there is a time for silence and a time for speaking, and show us when to speak and when we hold our peace. Never let us miss a cry for help because we are too busy talking about ourselves. Make us ready to listen to others because we listen each day in silence to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We collect our prayers into one as we say together the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.